This video demonstrates ways you can optimize Kusto Query Language. You use advanced hunting to combine, in new ways, the massive amounts of data that Microsoft 365 Defender logs to discover and understand threats to your enterprise. It uses Kusto Query Language, or KQL, to query all this data. In this video, I assume you have at least an intermediate understanding of KQL. If not, please have a look at our tutorial before continuing here. Moving on, this simple query joins the Identity Logon Events table to the Identity Info table to list all logon events and associated account information. Not a great performer here. It's returning the maximum number of results that the UX will return, which is 10,000, and it's taking a while to get those results. Keep in mind that I'm showing you this in my demo tenant. Imagine running this query in a large enterprise. That could be a problem, because each tenant has access to a set amount of resources allocated for running advanced hunting queries. Not to mention that unoptimized queries like this aren't making the best use of your time. After running a query, you see its execution time and resource usage, low, medium, or high, above the results. If you see high, that's a good sign that you could improve the query to return results more efficiently. Another great sign is when a query returns a very large number of results. To find out, use the count operator to see how big a query's result set might be. In this case, it's massive. Another clue that I might need to filter the query. Additionally, there's no way I'd ever be able to analyze all the data in the result set in a meaningful way. My recommendations here, and more at the page titled Kusto Query Best Practices, help you to get results faster and avoid timeouts when running complex queries. The single greatest way you can optimize your KQL is to use time filters and use them as early as possible. KQL is highly optimized for time filters, and if you use them early in your query, you limit the amount of data that the rest of the query must process. In this case, I'm restricting the results to identity logon events that occurred in the past hour. To do that, I'm taking items with a timestamp greater than 1 hour ago. As you can see, I got far fewer results, and I got them a lot faster. While my previous example filtered results between then and now, sometimes you need to look within a time range. For example, you might want to see logons 30 minutes before and 30 minutes after a particular time. To do that, use the between operator to describe the beginning and ending of the time range. Like the previous version of this query, it returns fewer results quicker than the original. This result set is something that I can more easily continue hunting in by filtering it further. There are many other ways you can improve your queries. First, when looking for full tokens in a column, the has operator works better than the contains operator, since it doesn't look for substrings. Obviously, use the contains operator if that's your intention. Second, use case-sensitive operators whenever possible. They're more specific and generally perform better. For example, use the has_cs operator instead of the has operator, and the equals operator instead of the equals tilde operator. You find a detailed list of string operators on the page titled String Operators. There's a lot of them, and this page indicates which ones are case sensitive and which aren't. There are many more subtle ways that you can improve your KQL queries. The article titled Query Best Practices lists a good number of them, so I encourage you to have a look at it. Things get more interesting, and performance can become more important when you start joining tables together. Keeping with the theme of filtering early, my biggest tip here is to filter the left table as much as you can before the join. In this case, I'm reducing the email events table to events that contain attachments and occurred in the last day. I do that before joining to the email attachment info table, resulting in a more efficient and more meaningful query. Even better, put the smaller table on the left side of your join, like you see here. By having the smaller table on the left, we have fewer records to match, which speeds up the query. However, the default join type is inner unique, which deduplicates the left table based on the join key. As a result, you might miss information that could provide valuable insight. Extra attachments on emails in this case. Therefore, consider using the inner join type if you're unsure whether you'll have duplicate keys in the left table. It's more costly, but will not perform the deduplication that happens with the default join type. The section Optimize the Join Operator in the article titled Advanced Hunting Query Best Practices lists many other ways you can create better joins in KQL. Have a look. Optimizing your KQL queries helps you get results faster and avoid timeouts, particularly when creating complex queries. To learn more about advanced hunting, I encourage you to see Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.